I want to talk about Antonin Scalia today, because I think when we understand Antonin Scalia, we can understand what's happening in the court system, how the crazy right is using the court system to make democracy disappear in this country. You know, old age sometimes takes a high toll on us. Achy joints and maybe trouble sleeping and failing energy. Now, we've all been there to observe the aging old curmudgeon who actually becomes less of a human being as suspicion and prejudice and fear and anger and pessimism begins to permanently obliterate the character and the persona of the 20 or the 30 or the 40 or the 50-year-old that at one time, inhabited a now aging 76-year-old body. It affects different people in different ways. We've all seen people grow older gracefully, and we've seen Antonin Scalia. A focus on our mortality, well, it can leave us wiser sometimes, and it can leave us more compassionate. It can increase our sense of decency and our sense of empathy. Sometimes that march towards the inevitable actually helps us develop an understanding that we're all, every one of us, we're all dependent on each other in some kind of way. No matter how small, we're all in this together. We're all hanging in this world together. It helps us understand sometimes as we get older and we become wiser. It helps us understand that we were put here as a family and we should try to live together as a family where we overcome struggle and we overcome despair together, where we celebrate our breaks, we celebrate our good fortune as a family together. And then there are the Antonin Scalias, the disturbing mutations of characters gone bad. Crippling age not only begins to eat away at his ability to think and his ability to reason, but age begins to have the effect of a cancer, gobbling up what we can only hope were the best parts of his character at one time. We hope he did have some good parts at one time. Almost a kind of leprosy where the first appendage to rot away is the Scalia compassion for his fellow man. Then after the Scalia compassion rots away, so does empathy. And then his insight and virtually all parts of emotion that were supposed to set him aside, set him apart from maybe the animal kingdom, the rest of the animal kingdom, maybe the ape. Maybe it's the process of aging, that march to the grave, that has put Antonin Scalia in a place where he has lost his sense of humanity, where he's incapable of recognizing human despair and human struggle and what he should be doing to make things better in this world. I read the dissent opinion of Antonin Scalia in the Arizona immigration case that was decided this week. And it helped me round out my mental picture of what Scalia has become. Without bogging down in all the details of what he said, the big picture is that Scalia has nothing but contempt for virtually everybody who's different from Scalia. Everyone who speaks a different language than Scalia. Everybody who follows a different religion than Scalia. Everybody who has skin that's a different color than the little Antonin. Everybody who has not been born into the Scalia anointed social class. Antonin Scalia is a sorry, hateful, morally crippled old man who will be shaping the future of this country until very old age, provides America some relief at last. Go online and read the dissent of Antonin Scalia in that Arizona immigration case, and it's going to fill in the blanks that you might have about Scalia and vicariously Clarence Thomas, who is his just joined at the hip. You're going to understand more about that old, dangerous Supreme Court judge who went duck hunting with Dick Cheney, flew in Dick Cheney's jet, stayed at the hunting lodge paid for with Dick Cheney money, and shortly after put his Supreme Court political black robe on and personally wrote an opinion that probably kept the little dick out of jail in the scandal that was developing around the secret closed-door energy meetings that every major oil company in the world participated in. That's the meeting where our barely human vice president told his close, hand-picked attendees that he was going to invade Iraq a full year before 9/11. We knew that. We knew that's what he said in those meetings, and we asked for the documents. That's where Dick told his energy pals that he'd personally assure them that he could gin up a war, a fake war in Iraq, and create a huge payday for all of them based on American blood. We know he did that, and we wanted to get the documents. And after that, our pathetic, old, morally crippled Supreme Court Judge Antonin Scalia, after the duck hunt, well, he helped Dick avoid any problems by issuing an order that kept those closed-door discussions a big secret. We know what happened, but we wanted to see it in black and white. And Antonin Scalia prevents us from understanding or ever seeing that. He's the same character, who for years now has tried to impersonate what's supposed to be a fair and impartial Supreme Court judge, as he's punished women, as he's punished minorities, as he's punished even America's disabled, as he's championed the rights of Wall Street fat cats, global polluters, and cheap, cheap consumer hustlers of every kind of description. That's Antonin Scalia's crowd. That's what old age has done to the little Antonin. Antonin, this is your day. Listen up and hear what listeners have to say about you. Your black robe, well, it's no longer an adequate camouflage. Your old aging mind is no excuse for the harm you deliver to democracy every day. The legacy you leave is no more attractive than the prospects you now face is a miserable old 76-year-old flying monkey that's regularly unleashed by corporate America every time they need you to do their ugly, ugly bidding. And the only bright side I see to all that is that your flight time is almost over.